Welcome to this week's edition of Today's Word. The Lord bless you. My prayer is that all these revelational teachings will bless your soul, will increase you, and will get you closer to God. In the name of Jesus, we are still on the subject of fear, fighting fear to finish. Fighting fear to finish. And today I want to talk about another common fear, and that is the fear of humiliation. The fear of humiliation, or you can call it the fear of shame, or the fear of reproach, the fear of worthlessness, the fear of humiliation. One Dr. Albrecht call this fear ego death. Ego death. Ego death in the sense that when you are consumed by this fear, everything about your ego is totally dead. You have no self-worth. You don't think, you don't place no value on yourself anymore. Your ego is completely dead. Now, the truth of the matter is that in life, nobody likes to be put to shame. Nobody likes to be embarrassed. Nobody likes reproach. So even as we live our lives, we do our best to avoid shame, to avoid reproach, to avoid humiliation, because it's not pleasant. It's not pleasant. In fact, sometimes the pains of humiliation can be so excruciating. So we do our best to avoid humiliation. However, and that is normal. However, when we become so consumed with the fear, that we might be humiliated, we might be put to shame, to the extent that the fear now controls us, then it becomes a problem. In fact, in psychology, this fear is under the social disorder. It is social anxiety disorder. It's classified under that, social anxiety disorder. So when it becomes so much that it controls you, then it's a problem, and we have to do something about it. Everybody wants to be loved, everybody wants to be lovable, everybody wants to have good relationship with others. We all want to, you know, have good esteem about ourselves. We want to look healthy, we want to have healthy relationships also with other people. We want to be valued by others. But sometimes in life, you know, things can happen that could tend towards shame or reproach. The question is, how do you deal with it? How do you deal with shame when it comes? Or how, you know, when you allow, you know, shame to the fear of shame to accumulate so much in you that it destroys your being, then it's a big problem. Now, this fear in itself can leave us physically sick. It can affect our physical body. It can leave us physically sick. It can make our skin to crawl or to flush. It can actually make your skin to begin to wrinkle, like you are aging fast. The fear of humiliation. And in some extreme cases, it can lead to, you know, it can make you feel like you have stabbing pains. It can give you stabbing pains in your body. And also, it makes you want to run into a hole just to disappear. And this is some of the social effect of this fear on those who have it. And also, it destroys your belief in your own self-value, your own self-worth. It destroys your belief in yourself. the fear of humiliation. And also, what does it do? It also destroys your ability to communicate. You know, it ostracizes you. It does not allow you to communicate with others. The fear of humiliation does not encourage you to build, you know, good relationship with others, because you have a fear that every attempt you make to relate with people will lead to shame. Also, it does not allow you to use your God-given skills very well or profitably. It does not allow you to use your potentials fully. Even people who are in the kingdom, I'm talking about Christians, the fear of humiliation can hinder you from praying. It can hinder you from leading prayer. It can hinder you from sitting even among the congregation. You always want to sit at the back. It can stop you from being a worker in the church, or even from being an active Christian. The fear of humiliation can be so terrible that it can destroy a person's personality. You know, the fear of humiliation can limit you in so many ways, you know, that if you are not careful, you know, you will not be able to make anything in life or make a headway in life. Now, what triggers this fear in people? What are the things that trigger this fear in people? One, the first thing is when you are constantly exposed to criticisms, especially harsh criticisms, you know, you might develop this fear. Those negative or harsh criticisms may begin to define your thought pattern, your self-value. You know, when you are constantly criticized, you feel you are made to feel that nothing you do is good, nothing you do is worthwhile, nothing you do, you know, gets approval from those especially who love you. So when you are constantly exposed to harsh criticisms or negative criticisms, you can develop this fear. Another thing that can trigger this fear is when you are constantly exposed to bullying. When you are being bullied, you know, maybe as a child you were bullied by your parents. You know, maybe your father was very harsh or your mother was very harsh, and every little mistake, you know, attracted very harsh judgment. Or when you were bullied by your older siblings or people in your neighborhood who are older than you and stronger than you, or when you are exposed to bullying even from your own mates in school. So constant exposure to bullying can trigger this fear in people. Another thing that can trigger it is victimization. You know, when you are being victimized often, or when you are a victim in certain, you know, cruel occurrences, maybe a victim of rape, a victim of armed robbery, you know, things that you suffered that you are afraid to even talk about because you feel it to humiliate you. You know, when you talk about these things, or when people see through, you feel people can see through even the facade, you know, that you have used to cover that shame. You know, so when you are constantly exposed to abuse, you know, then it can trigger this fear in you. And also, when you are in the habit of making grave mistakes all the time, I mean costly mistakes, you just, every little thing you try to do, you make mistakes that draw condemnation from people. So when you are in the habit of making costly mistakes, it can give birth to this fear. And so many things, even sometimes this fear can manifest in some minor issues in life. You know, maybe when you break a plate, you break a bowl in the house, and then you have this fear that others will laugh at you. Or maybe you burn food on the stove, you have this fear that people will laugh at you. You forget to, you know, acknowledge the birthday of somebody who is close to you. You have this fear that you might be looked upon. So this fear can manifest in so many different ways, and it can be triggered by so many things. The thing also is that if you have it, of course you know it. Most of the fears we are talking about, those who have them actually know they have this fear. And so when you have these symptoms in you, then please, you know that the fear of humiliation is operating in you and you need to overcome it. The question is, what do you do if you are constantly in fear of being humiliated? What do you have to do to overcome this fear? I have two things to tell you, two counsels to give. The first one is that you should believe in God. You should believe in God. You should believe in God. The Bible confirms this, that if you believe in God, those who believe in God will not be put to shame. That is what the Bible says in Romans chapter 10, verse 11. It said, those who believe in God will not be put to shame. And this is also repeated in Romans chapter 9, verse 33. Those who believe in God will not be put to shame. In Joel chapter 2, verse 26, those who believe in God will not be put to shame. So you want to overcome the fear of humiliation, the fear of shame, then believe in God. And secondly, learn to trust God. Learn to trust God. Put your trust in God. Believe that whatever God says he will do, he will surely do it. For instance, in Isaiah chapter 54, verse 4, God says, fear not, for you shall not be ashamed, and neither shall you be reproached. Fear not, for you shall not be ashamed, neither shall you be disgraced. That is the promise of God. If you trust God enough to hold and stand on his word, then this fear will not be able to operate in your life. So you just learn to believe in God and learn to put your trust in God. My prayer for you today, my brother and my sister, is that if you are afraid of experiencing shame over anything, it could be over your marital issue, it could be over your children, it could be over some ailment you have that you are, you know, it's a secret and you are afraid that this thing might be exposed and it will bring shame to you. Whatever it is that you are afraid might bring you shame, I pray that Jehovah will come into that situation. I pray that Jehovah will remove that fear from you. And I pray that your heart be filled with the peace of God, that you will believe indeed that God, who has promised that you will never be put to shame, is too faithful to fail. You will not be put to shame over your children, over your marriage, over your health, over your finances. Whatever that is making that fear to knock at the door of your heart, I decree that God takes over now. God will take over now in the name of Jesus. You will enjoy peace in Jesus' name. It is well with you. And until I see you in the next chapter, please stay safe, stay strong, and be happy. Amen.